Here on the Champs-Élysées from the protesters, many of whom seem to have come here from that call from the Gilets Jaunes to protest on this Bastille Day, 230 years on from the French Revolution. Just wanted to get you to look in the background. The protesters have been moving the barriers that were used to contain the crowds this morning for the military parade into the middle of the street, trying to block it from traffic. Palpable anger and tension on the streets, and we've seen clashes across Paris in this area around the Champs-Élysées throughout the Bastille Day. You can see some of the protesters are actually encouraging other protesters to come up closer to them now, I guess to show a strength of force of numbers. The tension rising, and that is tear gas or stun grenades. No, that's stun grenades going off that I think are now coming down from the security forces who are further up that street. As you can see, that cordon created there by the police, who are essentially also trying to protect themselves for what is an angry mob. Another angry mob. Is this the start of the revolution? That's what the yellow vests want. So far, it hasn't quite managed that. This is the tear gas that's now being deployed. As you can see, people are trying to kick it away, and we will have to move back at this point because that tear gas is very nasty and it spreads very, very quickly. So more clashes here in Paris, tear gas being deployed. Well, we've also been speaking to some of the protesters today to get a sense of why they are continuing this fight, why the Gilets Jaunes movement that many thought was over seems to have gained a little more traction today, at least in the capital.
I would sack everyone. Macron, Ecology Minister de Rugy, everyone. We are trying to get them all sacked, and we'll see what happens.
We have to protest over the right to survive. It's hard. I'm not happy with the Macron government because we're under the cosh. The Yellow Vest movement is legitimate, whether we're wearing a yellow vest or not. We're really been messed about in France.
This is about all the reforms which Mr. Macron is doing. The emergency services are striking, firefighters are striking, the hauliers will surely strike. So the French people are sick of it. The movement is never finished. Mainstream media are lying to the French people and even to Europe.
We always want to have something to eat in our fridge, like normal people. We need a salary to feel like we're living, and we can't live off the sweat of our labor. Can they explain to us why these taxes and everything keep growing? Petrol, electricity, water. Us, yellow vests, are still angry. We'll remain. We can't stop this. I've been fighting for 8 months to make ends meet.
Protesters, we have seen them lighting fires in the street and also appearing to be charging towards the police, particularly in anger when they think that other protesters are being held behind police cordons. Perhaps not the scenes that President Macron was hoping for this Bastille Day. This is, of course, a day that he's used in the past to show off to national leaders. President Trump came here 2 years ago to watch the military parade. And today his guests included Angela Merkel and Jean-Claude Juncker. Perhaps a day of when he was hoping to show the strength of not just the French military, but the strength of 9 other European countries that have come together to form an initiative which is looking for the protection of the defence of Europe. Perhaps not what he wanted to really show is that once again it's descended into some sort of chaos here on the streets, and some might question how you can look to defend a wider area such as Europe when you still have massive problems here on the streets of France, particularly with the Gilets Jaunes, who keep saying that there are problems with the social fabric of France, and many of them still calling for something again, 230 years on, a new revolution.
Local lawyer Philippe de Vieux thinks the protesters have not been heard by President Macron from the very beginning.
I came here to monitor the rights of honest citizens, ordinary people who are oppressed. The government is afraid, the President of the Republic says, we'll protect those places where powerlessness reigns. but those in power will also be protected, even if they move outside the law. And when the president passes through the Champs-Élysées, he's afraid that he may be booed. Well, this is political life when you're a president. You need to accept the anger of the people, along with their satisfaction. But it seems to me that he did not understand anything about the yellow vest movement, and that this autumn, total frustration awaits us.